Namo Dita Fa, good morning. Thank you for joining me for our daily practice check-in. Listen, listen, listen. This beautiful sound calls us back to our true home. The fifth mindfulness training. Aware of the suffering caused by unmindful consumption, I vow to cultivate good health, both physical and mental, for myself, my family, and my society by practicing mindful eating, drinking, and consuming. I will ingest only items that preserve peace, well-being, and joy in my body, in my consciousness, and in the collective body and consciousness of my family and society. I'm determined not to use alcohol or any other items that contain toxins, such as certain TV programs, magazines, books, films, and conversations. I'm aware that to damage my body or my consciousness with these poisons is to betray my ancestors, my parents, my society, and future generations. I will work to transform violence, fear, anger, and confusion in myself and in society by practicing a diet for myself and for society. I understand that a proper diet is crucial for self-transformation and the transformation of society. Today we're reading Everything is Mind Attended by Ajahn Amaro. This is from Beginning Our Day by the monastics of Abhayagiri Monastery. Even though the snow falls nearly every year, I'm always struck by the same impression, how much it changes the perception of the world I live in. Water arriving in a particular form, turning all the horizontal and semi-horizontal surfaces white, the sound and the shape, everything highlighted in a strange, unusual way, all the color washed out. It's a very good teaching, isn't it? It's like the mood of the mind. It can be so persistent when it's stuck on some track, excited, irritated, or worried about something. There seems to be a coloring of the whole world. This is my problem. I'm supposed to worry about this. I have to worry about this. This is my project. The only thing that really matters in the world is fixing the railings at the Bhikkhu Commons or clearing the trap under the sink at Casa Serena. The center of the world is this particular job we have, these letters that have to be written, or this meal that has to be cooked. These things that the mind latches onto seem so real and permanent. Our particular projects, responsibilities, fears, hopes, and desires. Well, of course it's that way, can't you see? Then suddenly, snap! Overnight, the world changes color, and there's a whole different mood. Suddenly, oh look, it's all different. How utterly transformed our perceptions can be when there is simply a different shape, coloring of the landscape, or sound of the valley. This is an excellent reflection on our moods. When we think we're in the middle of some difficult tangle, some big issue or conflict, an important project, a difficult relationship, suddenly it all shifts. Poof. It's not a problem anymore because it just changed. The thing that we thought we had to worry about wasn't anything we needed to be concerned about in the first place. It wasn't the way we thought it was. It was a mistaken impression. When we see and reflect in this way, how much the world can change when we're in the midst of some particular anxiety, worry, project, or activity, it helps to provide a perspective. Oh, this is only my impression. Now I see. We get caught up in thinking, I have my name written on this particular issue. It's mine. I'm responsible for this project. I have to dig this hole. I have to fix this railing. I'm the one who has to pay the debt. It seems so real and important, so much like it's the center of the world. We see what the mind has put onto it, what Lungpur Cha would call a mind-attended thing. He would say, everything is mind-attended. Even though in the Abhidhamma it says there are some things which are mind-attended and there are some things which are not mind-attended, Lungpur Cha would say, well, actually, everything is mind-attended. As soon as we know about something, we form an opinion, make a judgment, and create things with our thoughts. A simple event like a snowfall, a change of the landscape. And we're reminded that this particular thing that's so significant to us is only significant because of our particular conditioning, our particular expectations, fears, hopes, or abilities. The thing's significance is not inherent. It's merely something the mind has added onto the thing. With this realization, we can carry out the work we need to do. We can fix those railings, dig this hole, cook that food, answer those letters, and move that table around those difficult corners in a much more easeful and peaceful way. It's not the center of the world. We can see that it isn't so personal, so burdensome, or so much about me and mine. When we realize this, then everything we need to attend to, the events of the day and the responsibilities that we have, is much more natural and easy to carry out. It becomes more like breathing. The body does it on its own. It doesn't have to be me or the ego that does it. Gravity works on its own. I don't have to do gravity. When we start to function with that same kind of naturalness and easefulness, working and living in community becomes just like breathing. May all beings be well. May all beings be happy. May all beings be peaceful. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Thank you for joining me this morning.